हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे विल डिस्कस अबाउट ओम्स लॉ एंड रेजिस्टेंस। बिफोर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द ओम्स लॉ, लेट्स डू एन एक्टिविटी। सो यू कैन सी हियर, फॉर दिस एक्टिविटी वी नीड फोर सेल्स, 1.5 वोल्ट ईच, वन वोल्ट मीटर, वन निक्रोम वायर व्हिच इज एक्ट लाइक ए रेजिस्टेंस, एन एमीटर एंड ए की switch. So these five things we need: four cells, voltmeter, nichrome wire, ammeter, and a key. You know, the nichrome wire is actually, nichrome is an alloy which is made up of nichrome is made up of nickel, chromium, manganese, and some amount of iron. So it is a mixture of two or more metals and non-metals. So hence it is an alloy. So that alloy name is nichrome, which is high resistance. That's why we are using it. So these five things should be connected in this way: the cells, four cells, the nichrome wire, ammeter, and switch key should be joined in a series connection, and a voltmeter is connected to the nichrome wire in parallel. So in this way, if you'll connect it, now the switch is open. So if the switch, if we'll make it on, if the key is put here, then the current starts to flow from, this is the positive end, this is negative end, and it will flow like this. So exactly same thing, the circuit diagram of above electric circuit is done here. You can see here four cells are there, and each four cells, this is positive end, this is negative end, it is connected with a nichrome wire, then ammeter is connected, and the switch is connected in series, and voltmeter is connected in parallel, and this is the nichrome wire, which is given the blue in color. Okay, so what we'll do in this activity, actually, what we'll do, first of all, we will take only one cell. You know, the voltmeter and ammeter is, the voltmeter reads or measures the potential difference, voltage, whereas ammeter measures the amount of current flowing in the circuit. So when we'll make the switch on, when we'll make the switch on, if we'll put it here, then and what we'll do, we will take only one cell. We will take only one cell here, and if it is connected like this, then the voltmeter reading and ammeter reading, you have to find it out and write in a table. So as you know that one cell has only 1.5 volt, so the first case, voltage 1.5 volt, and the current in the ammeter is showing 2.7. So if you do this experiment, you will find it out. Then next, what we'll do, we will take two cells. Now we will connect another cell, and same experiment we'll do. So when the two cells will be there, then the voltage will become 1.5 plus 1.5, 3 volt, and the ammeter also show the different reading, and if the reading will measure, that will be 5.4. So like this, what you have to do, you have to find out the reading for 3 cells, then you will get this reading, and when we'll connect the 4 cells, then you will get the reading like this. So after finding out this voltage and current in a tabulation form, what we will do, we will divide this voltage with I, V upon I. If you divide this value, and you will find, if you divide by then you will find 0.55 in this case. Similarly, if you divide this, here also you will get 0.55. again, when you will divide this, so after each division approximately you will find all the value of V upon I will be 0.55. in this case, not always, it depends on the where. Actually, in this experiment you got the value of V upon I in each case, first, second, third, fourth, approximately 0.55, means V upon I becomes constant for every cases. And then if you do a graph between voltage and current, voltage is the other name of potential difference. If you take the potential difference and current, and if you do a graph, the x-axis is taken as current is taken in x-axis and voltage or potential difference is taken in y-axis, you will get a straight line. So what does it mean? That voltage and current are actually directly proportional to each other. It means if you increase the voltage, then current also increases in similar amount. So actually this activity, what I have discussed now, was experimented by Judge Simon Ohm in 1827. And he, after this activity, after this experiment, he formulated a law which is known as Ohm's law. And the Ohm's law states that, the statement of the Ohm's law is like this, that the voltage across a metallic wire is directly proportional to the current flowing through it, provided that temperature remains constant. Means the temperature of the experimental tools, the nichromware, should be constant. At constant temperature, the V is directly proportional to I. This is the Ohm's law. So if you write the statement of the Ohm's law, then it will be like this. The statement is, at constant temperature, the voltage or potential difference across a metallic wire is directly proportional to the current flowing through it. So the Ohm's law states that at constant temperature, the voltage or potential difference across the metallic wire is directly proportional to the current flowing through it. And if you write mathematically, then I can write in this way, or the potential voltage, you know, voltage is symbolized as V, is directly proportional to current I. Current symbol is I and the voltage symbol is V. But you have to mention here, at constant temperature. The temperature should remain constant in this experiment. Then you can find the V is proportional to I. And when will I can write in this way, or V equal to, so as I told that when we divide V upon I, it remains constant. So it means V divided by I equal to constant, and this constant actually named as resistance, which is symbolized as R. So here in case of this experiment or this metallic where the R becomes 0.55, so when the law is written, so what we do, we write the equal to, if you make the equal mark, you have to multiply a constant here where R is a constant called resistance. It means the R here is a constant which is known as a resistance of the wave. We'll discuss about the resistance. So this is all about the Ohm's law. The George Simon Ohm, after this experiment, he find out that voltage and current are directly proportional to each other. If you increase the voltage, definitely the current is also increases. And the relationship he found that V equal to I into R. This is all about the Ohm's law. Then we'll read about the resistance. What does it mean? So from the Ohm's law you got. Now from Ohm's law, we get V equal to I into R. And if you write, if you find out R, hence R equal to V upon I. So this is the formula for resistance. R is resistance, and resistance equal to voltage divided by current. Then question comes, what is actually resistance? It is a constant, no doubt. From the Ohm's law we got that resistance is a constant. Constant means it does not changes, its value remains same in all the cases, hence it is called constant. This resistance, if you find out the meaning of this resistance, the word resistance is actually coming from the word resist. You know, this is resistance. So one word is coming, resist. Resist means to oppose, to make block or obstacle. So what happens, students, whenever in a metallic ware, for example, this is a metallic ware, okay? In this metallic ware, you know that it is a solid and it is made up of particles, smaller particles called atoms. And when it is actually made up of or packed with many atoms, okay, maybe if it is a metal, it is similar atoms will be there, and if it is a alloy, then different types of atoms will be there. Then what will happen when, you know, what is current? Current is flow of charge. And actually the electron flows in a conductor, then only current exists. So when the electrons actually moves, for example, if an electron moves from this end, this is the one end and this is another end, left. And an electron moves through the space between the atoms and moving from this part to this part. So as you can see here, it is, there is no gap between them. The particles are tightly packed. So the electron, when it is moving from one end to another, it has to collide with other atoms. So the other atoms will give obstacle to them, the collision. They will hit the other atoms and find its way to move from this end to this end. Provided there will be a potential difference between them. Already we have discussed about it. As long as there will be potential difference between the two ends of a conductor, then only the charges flow from higher potential to lower potential and current will flow. So what I am telling that when electron flows from one end to another with collision with other atoms, this collision with other atoms gives a opposing force or obstacle to this flow. So to flow of current, when the actually charge is flowing means current is flowing, to the flow of current there is a obstacle or opposing force, and that opposing force is called resistance. So it depends on the conductor, depends on the different the material which gives the oppose, or you can say the obstacle to the flow of current. That property is called resistance. And if you define this resistance, then it will be, it is a property of a conductor to resist, or resist means oppose, the flow of current, that is charge, the property of a conductor to resist or oppose to the flow of, to resist or oppose to the flow of current. So it is a property of a conductor to resist or oppose to the flow of current through it. Means when the current is flowing, there is an opposing force which try to oppose or resist the flowing of current, and that opposing force is called resistance. Students, you can compare with the friction. You know, whenever any object is moving over another surface, so there is a frictional force X which oppose the flow of, oppose the motion of the object always. Frictional force is always opposing the motion of the object. Exactly same thing, the resistance is also one type of friction, you can say. It is also an opposing force which opposes the flow of current. So always resistance acts against the flow of current or flow of charge. This is the resistance. So now we will read about this resistance H. I have told the resistance will be differ from material to material. So from this formula, if we want to find out the unit, so the SI unit of resistance is ohm. You know, the ohm is also H. We have already read George Simon Ohm. The unit ohm is named after George Simon Ohm, who discovered the relationship between the voltage and current. The SI unit of resistance is ohm. The symbol of ohm is written H like this. This is actually a Greek letter. It is a Greek letter. This is not English or alphabets. It is a Greek letter which is actually in Greek language. It is pronounced as omega. So you can pronounce as omega, but whenever you will write, you don't write omega. You have to give the symbol of this omega. This is the symbol used for ohm. So either you can write ohm or the symbol omega. This is the SI unit of resistance. And if you want to define one ohm, so if you put the SI unit of all these quantities, then it will be 1 ohm equal to 1 volt by 1 ampere. I is the current, current SI unit is ampere, V is voltage or potential difference, SI unit of potential difference is volt, R is resistance, the SI unit of resistance is ohm. So I can write 1 ohm equal to 1 volt by 1 ampere. And if you make one sentence with this formula, then you can find out the definition of 1 ohm. So what we can define, how can I define the 1 ohm? I can define in this way, that if the voltage across a wire, metallic wire, is 1 volt and 1 ampere current is flowing through it, then its resistance will be 1 ohm. So in this way you can define 1 ohm, that if 1 volt potential difference is maintained across a metallic wire and 1 ampere current is flowing through it, then the resistance of the wire will be 1 ohm. So this will be the definition of 1 ohm, that if 1 voltage is the potential difference maintained across the two ends of a metallic wire and 1 ampere current is flowing through it, then the resistance of the wire will be 1 ohm. So this is all about the resistance, and Ohm's law we have discussed now. So we'll discuss the other parts of the resistance and specific resistance in the next session. Till then, bye bye.